When you close your eyes, you will see these earrings. Before you go to sleep, you will also see these earrings. When you finally fall asleep and you're dreaming of your favorite waifus, you will see that she is wearing these earrings. And then after you wake up, you will still see these earrings because you're watching my video and I'm showing you guys these earrings. And these ones too. What can I say? I guess the ladies do love the earrings. Hi, welcome back to another Princess Connect video. My name is Lace and today let's talk about preparing for the upcoming world. We've got like a whole bunch of hard modes coming out. We've got the Ilya node coming out. We've also got the fourth slot for rank 11 coming. And so we can just quickly talk through those ones. I am not going to do like a character by a character evaluation. I do think that the majority of you have eyes and have a brain now, especially if you guys have been following me for a while. And so I've just collated all of the resources. I'm just going to drop them into the description below. You already know how it is. However, through each of these resources, I am just going to like show you guys, make a couple of key call outs just to make sure that you guys understand there is a little bit of planning involved. And so with that being said, let's talk about the hard mode first. So this bad boy, Whoa, this is the new hard mode that is going to be released 17.3. It's going to be the Ilya node. And so as you can see, on top of fighting Ilya, we will also be fighting Lapras from Pokemon. It's like the greatest collab ever. And so what I have collated is a whole bunch of CN links in which they are putting together a whole bunch of like pretty much magic team comps. And there are some physical ones as well, but like the majority are going to be magical. And I'm showing these guys first because I know that there are a lot of people that actually still struggle with hard mode. And I don't blame you. It's actually pretty hard. I mean, that's why they call it hard mode, right, guys? Anyway, so the majority of them should be a 3-star clear on auto. And if you can't auto it, then I would say just give it a shot and like try to do some timings. And I think for this stage right here, the key call out is probably the Yukari Yubi. It is quite important because heck, you got a freaking Ilya standing right up the front and she is going to chunk all of your girls, okay? All right, and so this is the first team comp. We've got two tanks. Do not use Miyako. Miyako does not stand up to Ilya. But back to it, two tanks, two mage DPSs with defense down, and then you got Yukari. And then on the other hand, if I click into P2, there is another option. So this bad boy looks like, this bad boy looks like it is not available to us. So let's move on. But don't worry, guys, there are a couple of physical comps. So let's move on to this one over here. So this one involves a little bit of healing. And so again, auto 3 stars, H17-3. And so if we go over to the end, you'll see Ilya and Lapras. And then on top of that, a very, very similar idea to the other one. However, we've got the Yui. So I think that with the Yui, it is, you can probably use this one a bit more manually as well. What I mean by that is like your Yui, she can do the AoE heal. You don't want to like really run that on auto, same as the Yukari UB. And so yeah, if you guys are having trouble, definitely manual it. So like for example, your Skiaru after defense downs, and then looking for like the magical damage, like this guy. Look at that, guys. Look at that. That should really be blocked by the Yukari UB. And so as for choice of tank, I do want to talk about Jun as well as Kuka, because those are probably the two tanks that will thrive here, considering Kuka is your premier best magical tank and Jun is a very good second. Anyway, in terms of content about the stage, I think we're pretty good. So I'm just going to run through the other comps. So Misato instead of like the Yui. And so the next one is actually a playlist of all three of the hard modes. So as you can see, we have a physical comp here for H17-1, and then for 17-2 we have something, but let's have a look at 17-3 because typically that's the one that's going to give everyone trouble. And so guys, look, it's very similar, except in this case they are not going to be trying to block the magic damage. They're actually just going to straight up tank it and then heal through it. And so it looks like this guy has given us a second option. So if I click into that, we've got the Yukari again. However, we've got a Shiori, which is pretty interesting. Regardless, I think you guys are starting to get the pattern of it. There is a tank, there is typically going to be a Yukari, and you've got like the range DPS. The range DPS stands away from Ilya and it should be pretty gravy. So yeah. And so guys, just scrolling through real quick, this one over here, I wanted to show you, this is the physical comp. This is actually the only physical comp that I found where it features a double archer as well as the summer Kokoro. So again, pretty much the same ideas, but I think we have done this topic to death. And so with that being said, let's move on. All right guys, so for the next segment, let's start talking about rank 11 4 versus 10-6. So shout out to Miss Niara. You guys already know who she is. She does like these really elaborate sheets. And in addition to that, we've got to thank Chocolate as well. So yeah, he's pretty much done the same thing, except some people would say that this is probably more geared to CB. However, before going through these two lists, I do want to say like, keep them at the lowest rank that you can and just pre-farm. Because the CB that we're going into, there is actually not a lot that we can translate over from the other servers. And so what that means is that all we can do is like look at the theoreticals over here. So like, for example, these guys are only gaining stats, right? And so we should definitely go for like 11-4 for these mages over here. However, there are a couple where it's kind of like, oh, I'm not 100% sure, like a Samatamaki, like Jita, we got Shiori down here. So yeah, in my opinion, pre-farm for like, especially for these guys first, you got your priorities. 11-4 is clearly the best rank. If you're CB focused, take all of the CB focused units. You already know who it is. It's going to be Jun. It's going to be your Kari, Eriko. It's going to be your Christina. It's going to be your like your Akari and the rest of your mages. It's going to be your Suzuna and so forth. And so this chart is really great because I love seeing these like massive numbers. And so again, I am not going to go through each one of these because I'm going to bore you to death, but there is a key call out and it's these guys over here. And so if you have a look at like the majority of the physical DPSs, what you're going to realize is that 11-4 is going to introduce a pair of earrings. These guys here. And so these earrings are probably going to be the bane of your existence for like the next few weeks, if not months, but they are like fully worth it because they are giving you accuracy. So that is like the bolded text over here. Like, look at that accuracy, my guys. It's going to be giving you the accuracy as well as the crit rate, which is really freaking good. And so hopefully that gives you a little bit more reliability, especially in arena. I don't know about you guys, but like it's been a very, very Miyako dominant arena because like she's gotten her 11-3, like her tanking thrive in that kind of meta, and my archers are not hitting any Miyakos. Like, they freaking aim at her and then they just kind of like shoot off in the other direction. Anyway, so that is probably one of the key callouts, is this earring over here, and I think you're going to be farming about 700 to 800 of these bad boys. And that is probably from like both a CB and an arena perspective. You can probably take like only about 60 to 70% of that if you're just going on like CB. But honestly guys, that is still like monumental. That is an insane amount of farming for just these earrings. On the other hand, I want to introduce you guys to another set of earrings. And so these earrings are also pretty freaking cracked, but like these, you're going to be farming a lot of them as well. I would guesstimate probably like 300 to 400 of these guys. But as you can see, the priority is obviously very, very different, right? Like it's mainly for your tanks and like some of your supports. And so what that means is that your main focus is going to be on these guys down here. Like, look, it's all of your DPSs, right? And so to hopefully help you guys plan it out a little bit better, I want to introduce you guys to this one over here. And a lot of you probably already know about this site, but essentially this is your quest helper. So you can like actually input a lot of the different gears or a lot of the different characters that you're looking to build. And then after that, it's going to show you like the most efficient stage to farm. So for example, if I need these scarlet males as well as these firing things, I want to be farming 15-3. And so let me add a couple more. So for example, if I wanted to take my Miyako up as well, I'm going to want those. I'm going to want like these bad boys over here. I'm going to come down a rank. I'm going to want like more of these guys. Then like, as you can see, 16-12 as well as 17-12 is going to give me like full coverage over items that I require. However, it does not mean sync all of your stamina into 16-12 because as you can see, it does not cover the earrings, which is probably our most wanted gear. And so yeah, that's this helper over here. You can change a lot of the settings. Like you can set the highest quest chapter for us, which is going to be 17. You can have it ignore like the hard quests and just go for the normal quest because that's where you'll probably spend most of your time farming. And then you can also like save profiles and a whole bunch of other stuff. That's really cool. But yeah, I just really look at it for more of just like at a glance, what should I be farming? And so if you guys are having trouble keeping track, I would recommend this tool over here. And I swear that there is another one, like a CN tool, which was still English. I cannot remember where to find it. But if anyone has been around for a while and you do know what I'm talking about, it's essentially this, but a little bit like I liked that tool more. But yeah, it's essentially the same thing. It's a little bit different. I definitely saw it at launch. I just can't find it right now. And so if you do know what I'm talking about, I'd really appreciate it if you dropped it into the comments below. But anyway, all of that said and done, I think that actually might be it. And so to summarize, I've given you guys a whole bunch of these 17-3 auto videos, hopefully auto. And remember, if you guys cannot auto it, manual the Yukari and the Yuis at least. And then after that, we covered these two sheets over here, a couple of the key highlights. I think these are fantastic sheets. If you guys do want a little bit more logic, just check out like one of my older videos on the equipments. I essentially run through the logic as to like, well, should I go or should I not go? And the logic is generally, if you're losing a lot of boost or if you're losing a lot of retain, then you're not going. And so if I just scroll through here, you're going to see like the majority of the characters, they are going to be losing a lot of boost or retain if they are like at the lower marks. So I'm saying like Makoto is going to lose 15 boost and it's not worth all of these upgrades here. And then Shinobu, and then Ruka, and Tsumugi, and Akino, Hiyori, it's same. And so if you guys do have any specific questions, just drop them into the comments below. But otherwise, moving on, this is also a great summary. I am very appreciative of Chocolate and Miss Niara's work for the community. Me personally, I feel like we're losing a lot of content creators or a lot of like guide writers. Anyway, moving on, I introduced you guys to the earrings and the second set of earrings, and then also this quest helper. And so yeah, I think that's pretty much it. And I see this Halloween Misaki banner. Oh God. Oh God, because I don't know if I am gonna be rolling on this bad boy yet. I want to, I really want to. I guess we'll find out in about 12 hours time. I might go live for it. I've set in something tentatively. I don't know, we'll see. But aside from that, I do see the Tower of Luna coming up in a day or two. And so I will be coming out with a guide for that one as well. But that essentially wraps up the video. And so with that, I wanna leave you guys with a secret message, and that is earrings. Because that is all you're gonna be thinking about for like the next few weeks, if not months. And so if you guys would kindly drop that secret message earrings down into the comments below, I would really appreciate that, because it means you watched up until the end of the video. And so thank you guys so much. But otherwise, please consider a sub, follow, comment. You already know what it is. And if you would like to support the channel, in the description we've got affiliate links as well as a membership thing. But otherwise, as a pair of earrings once said to me, all good things must come to an end. And I don't know if that's believable or not, but regardless, thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye bye.